What's up, everyone? I got a good question from a different video. It was a comment under the video from Clark Chambers. What about having a separate ground rod for each sub panel? He was asking on the video, why do we bond at the service panel and not at the sub panel? So if you recall from that video, I talk about actually bonding our neutrals and our grounds together. Let me get a different color on here. So the point at which our ground rod hits earth, it could be a concrete encased electrode, it could be a ground rod, ground ring, there's all kinds of different things that we can use to establish our connection with earth. But in this case, we have a ground rod that's connecting our the rest of the premises wiring system to earth. And we're bonding the neutral. All neutrals need to go back to the main neutral so that we can complete a circuit if we have a fault, and that'll actually trip a breaker. But I was talking about how we have different sub panels, right? You can run more circuits over, and you just have to make sure you run an equipment grounding conductor, not a grounding electric conductor, an equipment grounding conductor to each one of the panels. But he was asking, what about having a separate ground rod for each panel? Can you do that? And the answer is yeah. I mean, you can put as many ground rods into anything as you want. You can put 17 ground rods, like if you're out at your service and you want out here to run like a whole crap load of ground rods, that's totally fine. You can't make them any closer than 6 feet apart. You have to make them further than 6 feet apart. And I believe there's even an informational note that says that double the length of the rod is like the most effective way of doing it. But there's no difference in doing this than there is in just running ground rods from other panels. Where it becomes tricky is you can't bond your ground and your neutral at each one of the panels, because then that gives you objectionable current potentially. You have two different paths that current can take. You could have a short go through the equipment grounding conductor and go through the neutral. And now the equipment grounding conductor is touching everything metal. So current's always gonna take all paths back to source, right? You always have the saying of current's always gonna take the least resistant path to ground. No, it's gonna take all paths that it has, and it's gonna take them in proportion to the amount of resistance or impedance that's offered to that current flow. So if you have seven conductors that are all connecting to each other, and each one's a little bit smaller, a little bit bigger conductors, you're gonna end up having current take multiple different paths, but the amount of current that's gonna take each path is gonna be dependent on how much resistance it can get. But if it's a complete circuit, it's still gonna take that either way. So you don't wanna give it multiple paths between all these different panels. So just make sure if you're gonna have supplementary ground rods, which is allowed by code, however many of them you want, just don't connect them to neutral at any of the sub panels. Just make sure each ground rod goes to the ground bus, has an equipment grounding conductor that goes to the next panel. You got an equipment grounding electrode conductor that goes down to the ground bar for the next one, that it's connected to the equipment grounding conductor. And the only place that you make a bond to neutral is still at the service. Super, super important. But yes, look up supplementary ground rods in Article 250, and it'll say like you can put them in. You can have supplemental ground rods. They're not required in some instances. And if you do use them, you do these. But it never says that you can't use more of them. So you just always have to remember that the National Electrical Code is a minimum standards guideline. It's just, this is the bare minimums. If you want to run way bigger conductors, if you want to put, you know, like more protection on something, you're absolutely okay to do that. But code definitely specifies that you do not make that neutral to ground bond except at the service disconnecting means. So good question, dude. Thank you so much. See you guys in the next one.